When God called you and me, He invited us to take part in something rather unique. He invited us to embrace life and live life to the full. But He also called us to surrender our heart and to embrace the mystical marriage, the Hierus Gamus. And He allows us to live in the world and not run away. He allows us to retain our name, and He allows us to be human and free of dogma and structure. He allows us to be free, to celebrate His love with nature and the animal kingdom. He allows us to be true to our heart and say yes to love or no. And though many are called to the banquet, to be in the presence of God, only a few remain, because it's not about me and I and having my own way. It's about listening to the heart and being directed by God. And automatically we become the golden word. We are one in essence and truth. And though many give lip service to God in different beliefs, their lip service will not win them a seat at the table of God, because their hearts are distant from God. Their hearts, sadly, are more preoccupied with ego and adulation of ego and winning the approval of their peers and others. And you and I have seen that, and we're seeing it today in the church, in religious families. And it is the ordinary people who are suffering. And that's why Francis came into existence with Claire. To bring support and love to the ordinary people who are crying out to embrace God. And today, many beautiful souls are following the teachings of their spiritual teachers and seeking a life away from the busy highways and living an ordinary but unique life by doing the simple things like washing, cleaning, cooking, befriending, praying, but doing it as a prayer. We are so blessed to have this channel where we can unite without compromising our belief or our teachings, where we can sit in the presence of God and know we are loved. And we also know that we don't have to do anything to win the approval of God. And all that is asked of every child of God is to be still, like now, and receive. Receive what? A new car? A new house? A new partner to share your life? The number for the lottery? No. To receive something much better. Inner peace. A peace that this world cannot give us. But an inner peace that is vibrant, living, healing, empowering. It's a peace that challenges all of the children of God to choose whether to surrender their heart to love or whether to walk away from love. Let us celebrate. And I share with you two quotes from His Holiness the Dalai Lama. And the first quote, interestingly, as you sow, so you reap. Happiness comes from kindness. Happiness cannot come from hatred or anger. And you and I will have witnessed elements of this reflection in your own daily struggles with God. You will have encountered well-meaning friends who come bearing gifts, but who very soon take the food from your cupboard and leave you hungry and bereft. And that is one thing the Christ would never do, is to leave a child starving of love. So we embrace the whole family of God, and if others choose to reject and walk away, we bless them and we release them to God. And he says the ripple effect, if an individual human being eventually becomes a nice, calm, peaceful person, then it automatically brings some kind of positive atmosphere and you have a happy family. And there lies the truth. For in all families, there is always one or two who creates the ripple effect of unease, discord, discontent, unhappiness. And often it's because they're not getting their own way. But in service to God, it's not about getting your own way. It's about God having His way with you. By empowering your heart to see the face of God in every child of God. And it's about not taking the spoon of porridge from the hungry child, but giving them your spoon of porridge to ensure that they're replete and content. It's about going the extra mile. It's about putting yourself last and that child of God first. It's about loving your neighbor as yourself. But the world we live in, though it is a beautiful world, it is a world that's become ingratiated with selfishness. And you see it wherever you go. You see it on the bus, where an elderly person or a disabled person is left standing whilst a younger person chooses to sit. And when challenged to stand up, they say, I paid for this, let them stand. Or if you ask them to pray with you, oh, they're too busy. But yet, we are all a bag of tricks. And I guess our God has a greater sense of humor than I do. But this one thing about being in service to love, lies and deceit are not a part of the victory. Those who lie and deceive, they are always reprimanded by God in a loving way. But we who have gathered here have come with a clean heart, a pure heart, and all we ask is for the willingness to receive. For many of us that is difficult, because for many of us we've had to survive the hard way from the hard knocks of life, and it's not so easy to receive, but easier to give. Let us be still now. Let us allow the Beloved give to us the promise of interior peace, a gracious heart, an abundant life, an abundant life. Let us relax now in our mind, in our body, and in our spirit as we come into the presence of God. This God I refer to is the one true, omnipotent, omnipresent, holy God. And he calls you and me to sit a while and be still. And in our sitting, in our relaxing, we are aware of his sixth sense. It's an interior feeling. It's at soul level. There are no words to describe or define it. It is an inner knowing. It's an intuitive knowing that we are loved. If all else fails and all else reject us, we know in our heart that God would never reject us. If we remain loyal and truthful to the calling he has given us. So let us allow him come to us. Let us allow him touch us, and as we breathe in, we can sense the smell and fragrance of frankincense. The angels are coming. Yes, we can hear the thuribles with the incense burning the praises of God, and now we see angelic beings before us with the incense of frankincense, and they cleanse our room of any bad energy that may have been sent to us. They cleanse it so that the Christ can stand in our presence. And here he comes, the barefoot Galilean, simply dressed, ordinary in appearance, disheveled hair from the sun and bleached because of the intensity of the sun, and a brown skin from working and ministering in the bright sun. And he stands before us. And we are about to stand up, and he says, "No, sit, my beloved. Be still and listen to me. You do know I love you. You do know I love you." Will you receive a gift from my hand? You're hesitant, and he asks you why, but he reads your thoughts. Those whom I have called are worthy. Those whom the world calls may appear worthy, but they are unworthy. I call you friend, because you do the will of him who sent me. And I want to present to you a gift. It is an invitation to come follow me. And I promise you life everlasting. I promise you a place in my Father Mother's kingdom. Will you come? But it won't be easy. It will be tough going at times, when many will come to you and say, oh, I love Jesus and Francis, but beware of them, for their hearts are far from me. They give lip service to God, and there's no guarantee for them. But you who are willing to surrender and allow me lead your life, I will take you to paradise. I will allow you see the face of God. Be still and know that God is with you, that God is within you, that God is all around you. Come, you whom my Father has blessed, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of time. Be at peace now, and sense my touch on your heart as I release the chains of unworthiness from your heart, and I bring to you now your beloved. I bring to you angels of high rank to watch over you. I bring to you love, peace, and joy. Receive my healing touch to all those painful memories, and receive my gift. Come follow me. Come follow me. Come follow me. In your hands. If you receive it, that is your gift. And if you reject it, I will still love you. There is no pressure to surrender your heart to my heart. Everything I do for you is done in love. Become my heart. Become my heart. And be my feet and my hands. And set captives free. The message from Jesus to share with you now is very simple and very beautiful. Keep your eyes on me. Waves of adversity are washing over you. and you feel tempted to give up. As your circumstances consume more and more of your attention, you are losing sight of me. Yet I am with you always, holding you by the right hand. I am fully aware of your situation, and I will not allow you to be tempted beyond what you are able to bear. Your greatest danger is worrying about tomorrow. If you try to carry tomorrow's burden today, you will stagger under the load and eventually fall flat. You must discipline yourself to live within the boundaries of today. It is in the present moment that I walk close to you, helping you to carry your burdens. Keep your focus on my presence in the present. And there we have a clear instructions from the Beloved to our heart. And now let us play Amazing Grace. For we are that amazing grace. For out of our woundedness and brokenness and disheveled life, through many knocks and trials, the Lord God has touched us and set us free to become Amazing Grace. I dedicate it to you. And I say good night and God bless. Divine within and without us. God bless you. Namaste.